Her face is shown clearly, sir.
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
We are live.
Thank you. A warm welcome to everyone present here. Students of today or students of tomorrow. So today, children of seventh class are going to present on their social responsibility on the topic Animal Kingdom. So they are here to all sit ready to present on all the animals, like wild animals, domestic animal, pet animals, and extinct animal. And what are their responsibility to safeguarding all these animals? So they are all set ready. Without making delay, let us start the show. Over to the first, we will start with wild animal. Over to Peter Manoj.
Thank you, Sirendraji. Good morning. I'm happy to be part of a great event, My Social Responsibility. Thank you, Veda ma'am, Gita ma'am, and Surendra sir, and all the branch principals and the wonderful parents who supported till now and for the future days also. What is social responsibility? Social responsibility is an ethic theory that every individual should have in their lifetime. And why it is important? We are human, so this is important that we have to take some responsibility on what we have going to do. Our students are here to present and view and give some ideas about their responsibilities, and they have chosen and we have chosen the Animal Kingdom, and my team has taken the topic on wild animals. Here they are.
Thank you, Peter Manoj. Thank you, Peter Manoj. Before we start, I request our HOD ma'am, Ms. Vedavati ma'am, to share a few words to our children, ma'am.
Thank you, Surinder, and thank you, Peter. I think that was a very good explanation about the responsibility towards every individual, Peter. I completely agree with you. And it's very happy to know that the students of Narayana Group of Institutions started off on early days taking up the responsibility, and especially towards my favorite topic of Animal Kingdom. They're very, very close to our heart. Animals, you know, are something that we live with them. So that is something that, you know, I'm looking forward and also trying to, you know, understand as students, what is that they're going to do to safeguard the Animal Kingdom, whether it is wild animals, pet animals, or extinct animals, whatever it is, right? So thank you, students, for taking up the responsibility. And that's the best way that you can grow in your life. Thank you all, and all the very best.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank
for
you,
your
ma'am.
Blessings. I request Geeta so ma'am also to share a few words to our children, ma'am.
Thank you, Surinder. Good morning, everybody, all the students. I wish you all the success as you begin the new journey called My Social Responsibility for 7th class. This should be go with a long, long process of new learnings, new projects. All the best, 7th class.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much for your blessings, ma'am. Okay. Now it's time to start. Let us start with wild animals. The stage is yours, children.
Wild animals. Yes. Thank you, Surendra. So wild animals, it's a big part and wide kingdom of wild animal kingdom. It's a big part, wild animals. So a small team is going to present on that thing, that topic. And I call upon Pooja Vasudevan to start.
Thank you, sir. A very good morning and a warm welcome to one and all present here. I am Pooja Vasudevan of Class 7 from Chennai, Pural branch. Me and my teammates are all gathered here to give a presentation on wild animals. Before we move further, on behalf of my team, I would like to thank our school management for giving us this wonderful opportunity. I would also like to thank our HOD ma'am, our principals, TL madam, regional soft skills trainer Surendra sir, Peter Manoj sir, and all our soft skills trainers, teachers, and our supportive parents who have guided and helped us throughout this process. Now, I would like to introduce my creative team of members and the topic that they're going to be presenting. Myself, Pooja Vasudevan, going to start off this presentation with the introduction part and a few facts about wild animals. From there, my friend Divilakshmi will be taking over the following topics: role played by wild animals and what will happen to the earth if there are no wild animals. Saif Hussain will be presenting the importance of wildlife. Following from there, Akshaya will be sharing some information about the endangered species of wild animals and then the government's the steps that the government has taken to save wild animals. Next, Layalini will be presenting the following topics: barriers and threats for wild animals and tourism. Is it a boon or bane? Once again, Saifi Hussain will be there presenting some information about the surveys, presenting the role of social media in saving wild animals. From there, Anna Aguilan will be delivering some information about the surveys of wild animals in the last 10 years. Next, myself, Pooja Vasudevan, will be sharing some ideas and ways in which you can save wild animals. And finally, Hujan Ram will be presenting my responsibility in saving wild animals, and he will be concluding the presentation. So now that we've seen who's going to be presenting what, I would like to give a small introduction on wild animals. What are wild animals? Well, wild animals are animals that live isolated from humans, and they prefer to live on their own with their own species. Wild animals don't rely on humans for food, water, shelter, or any other basic necessities. They play an important role in balancing the environment and the food chain. They mostly live in areas like forests, rainforests, deserts, grasslands, and many other places. Now, here are 10 incredible facts about wild animals that you may have not heard of before. A shrimp's heart is located at the bottom of its head. Why? It is for protecting the main organs. For shrimps, having organs located in their head is much more advantageous and safer than having them located in the tail part, because the head is covered with a thick protective substance. It is much safer to protect their internal organs. Snails need moisture to survive, so if the weather is not cooperating, they can actually sleep up to 3 years. It has been reported that snails can shift between hibernation and estivation, helping them to escape harsh climates. Koalas have fingerprints that are almost identical to human ones, so much so that fingerprints of koalas and humans have made difficulties in the job of police and people. Elephants are the only animals that can't jump. This is because they are heavy and mostly because they don't know how to jump, unlike other animals. A rhino's horn is made out of hair. Rhino's horn is made of the same material as your hair or nails, a protein called keratin. The center of the rhino's horn is made of calcium, surrounded by a thick layer of keratin. A cow can give nearly 200,000 glasses of milk. That is 2 lakh glasses of milk. That's a lot of milk. An ostrich's eye is bigger than its brain. Ostrich is the largest bird in the whole world, having the largest eye in the whole animal kingdom that are even bigger than its brain. It is about 2 inches or 5 centimeters in diameter, making it perfect for the terrestrial lifestyle. The next fact is really weird. An octopus has 3 hearts, 9 brains, and blue blood. 2 of the hearts pump blood to the gills, while the 3rd circulates it to the rest of the body. There is 1 central brain and 8 small brains at the base of each arm, which controls movement. Gorillas can catch human colds and other illnesses. Gorillas are prone to human diseases and many respiratory illnesses that afflict humans. This is one reason why tourist tracking gorillas are not normally permitted to get too close. The last fact, jellyfishes have no brains or hearts. Then how do they live? Well, jellyfishes, instead of having a single centralized brain, they possess a net of nerves where the neurons send chemical signals to their muscles to move so that they can swim and perform other activities. So that's all the facts that I wanted to share with you all today, and I hope that it might have been helpful. Thank you for your attention. Over on to my friend Divyalakshmi.
Thank you, Pooja. You have shared a valuable point. Hi, everybody. I am Divyalakshmi from Pural Bench. I have 2 topics to share with you all. My first topic is role of wild animals in ecosystem. Directly or indirectly, wild animals play a very important role in our ecosystem. These are some points I am going to share with you. The sheer amount of wildlife, both known and yet to be discovered, play a very integral role in maintaining the fragile balance that ensures the wellness of the earth. Each species functions with a specific role. Today, predators, prey, decomposer, preservers, and this way ecological balance is preserved. Nowadays, in our modern time, humanity has managed to separate itself almost entirely from nature, which includes our animal relatives. It comes as no surprise that the majority of the human species is even afraid to consider themselves animals, mammals, much related to them, or even displaying anything closely animal behavior. Before the dawn of the great industrialization of the world, people have endeavors to separate themselves from wildlife, the ecosystem, and the earth in general. Now, with slowly diminishing number of tribal cultures, majority of humanity has utterly diverged from the original state of living common to all inhabitants of the earth, considering most wildlife as a mere means of sustenance, or even a hindrance of the ever-growing tide of human progress. My second topic I'm going to share with you is what will happen if no wild animals are there in our earth. Some tree cutters are afraid to go to forest for wood because of some wild animals. If wild animals are not there, then all the tree cutters will cut all the trees and the earth will be a barren land. If the plant and animal disappear from the earth's surface, then the ecological balance will be disturbed. Biodiversity means biological diversity. There are many animals and plant species on our planet spread all over the world. These animal and plant species, including humans, are all interdependent. Each species has its own play and role to play in the environment and help in the maintaining the ecological balance. That's why it should be conserved. If animals disappear, including humans, then the earth will be a barren land. The carbon dioxide in the world will decrease and break the layer of the atmosphere. This leads to the burning of earth and the gravity of the earth will decrease. The earth can also break apart. If there are no wild animals, there will be no humans too. Suppose if there are no animals, so there will be no one to look after the forest. Tree cutters would cut all the trees, so we would not get oxygen to breathe and we would die. There would be no life on earth. So this shows that plants, animals and human beings are interrelated to each other. If one of the three is missing, the life of other two will be in danger. So that wild animals should be conserved. Over to my friend Saifi Hussain.
Thank you, Divyalakshmi. Hi friends, respected teachers and madam. My name is Saifi Hussain from class 7 and I am studying in Narayana Olympiad School. Today, my topic is importance of wildlife. We often don't pay much attention to this question as we consider it's useless, or if we do, we have a limited improper knowledge. Wildlife is ingredient and needs more focused attention, which is not so tough when explained in an easy manner. Here we deal with this question. Indicators of environment health. Even though we have made so many advantages in technology, we still need nature in order to survive. Wildlife is essential to harmony of nature. Source of medicine. Animals are not meant for manufacturing medicines, but the coefficients of animals and plants is important. It helps in many ways. Like example, from wild forest we get ointments and cure for cancer or HIV or acid. Source of medical treatment. Similarly, in medicine, the development of new drugs and treatments depends on greatly on wildlife. Thank you. Over to my friend Akshaya.
Thank you, Saifi Hussain. I'm A.M. Akshaya of Madurai branch. I'm going to give a speech on endangered species in wild animal. Do you know what is endangered species? Yes, an endangered species is an animal or a plant that considers risk extinction. Nowadays, plants and animals are extinguishing towards a large portion of a range. National Endangered Species Day is celebrated on 3rd Friday, May month across the country to raise awareness about the endangered species of flora and fauna. A endanger is a sign that ecosystem is slowly falling down. And do you know how many species are there? Yes, there are 41,415 species are there in International Union Conservation of Nature in Red List. And I'm going to tell some endangered animals that are Asian lion, Bengal tiger, snow leopard, Nilgiri tiger, Kashmiri red tag, black buck, one-horned rhinoceros, gorilla, sea turtles, African wild elephants, sea lions, and Indian elephants. And I'm going to tell other topic to you as step taken by the government. In Wildlife Protection Act of 1972, Government of India created the protected areas like national parks and sanctuary and conservation and reserves, community reserves of wildlife, and imposed punishment on individual and illegal act of hunting. The special organism like Wildlife Institute of India and Bombay Natural History Society and Salim Ali Center for the Ornithology and Natural History are formed to conduct the reserve and conservation of wildlife. And there are 89 national parks, for 19 wildlife sanctuaries were also introduced by the government to protect the wildlife. And for restocking the endangered species, the central government first initiated the integral development of a wildlife habitat scheme and later modified it, including a new component, recovery of endangered species, which include animal. The Government of India intensified the anti-poaching activities and initiated the special patrolling strategy for the monsoon season also deploying the anti-poaching squad. The Indian Wildlife Act is passed by the government in 1972 for the protection for the plants and animal species. The government has banned the poaching and hunting for the animals, provided legal protection to their habitats. The central and state government has established many wildlife sanctuaries and national parks to the protect the forest wildlife. Government has chosen that the volunteer is the best way to conserve wild animals. So I'm requesting everyone that conserve animal by the way of volunteer. Thank you. Over to my friend Layalini.
Thank you, Akshaya. Good morning, one and all present here. I'm Layalini from Madurai branch. Here I am to talk about two topics. One is barriers and threats of wild animals. Another is tourism, boon or ban. What is barriers of wild animals? Well, wild animals across the world forcefully taken from the wild, torn away from their family for entertainment, which is a no life for them, which is cruel and abusive. It has been bred in captivity artificially. They have been trained intensively with pain to interact with people. They spend their entire lives in captive conditions and cannot meet their needs by themselves. While viewing, scare away the animals, disrupt their feeding, nesting site, assimilate them to people. Threats to wildlife. Wildlife are under threat from many different kinds of human activities, from directly destroying habitat to spreading invasive species and diseases. Most ecosystems are facing multiple threats. Each new threat puts additional stress on already weakened ecosystems on their wildlife. Here are some examples of threats of wildlife. They are global climate change is causing sea ice to melt, hydroelectric power developments, oil spills that occurs through oil explosion and development, and transportation pollute key habitats, increased shipping and oil explosion, industrial pollutants, and ever-increasing human population, inadequate law enforcement mechanisms, lack of conductive mechanisms for public participation in wildlife conservation process, inadequate financial and logistic support in conservation areas, insufficient information for wildlife resources of the country, and lack or absence of awareness about the values of wildlife. Here are some snapshots of wildlife suffering. They are extreme resistance to chains or cages, limited socializing with other animals, participation in stressful and harmful activities to entertain the people, inadequate nutrition and diet, insufficient veterinary care. My second topic is tourism, boon or ban. The main objective of wildlife tourism is to protect our wildlife. The funds collected from this tourism is a non-consumptive activity and is used to maintain the wildlife sanctuaries and national parks by the government. Negative impacts of wildlife tourism. The growing interest of developing countries in traveling through created a boom in the economy of the country. It can cause significant disturbance to animals and natural habitats. Thank you all. Over to my friend, Saif Hussain.
Thank you, Layalini. Hi friends, again I am here. And now my topic is social media in saving wildlife. Social media can play a huge role in helping protect wildlife. Being a part of information age is incredible and overwhelming at times. But I can't help be optimistic that we are in a better place than ever before to save wildlife. It helps to keep the importance and beauty of our earth in the hearts and minds of people. The data we collect on wildlife specimens is incredibly important and needs to be accurate. Using social web and community tools, we can effectively update databases through online databases and cut back on the time that passes before the information is collected. It's a personal belief that social media can play a huge role in helping protect wildlife. Social media posts opportunity like our being becoming more important than our animals' lives. Social media has been great term in helping wildlife awareness and educating the masses about our environment conservation and endangered species. Thank you. Over to my friend Anna Aguilan.
Thank you, Saif Hussain. Good morning to all present here. My name is Anna Aguilan. I am from Palaram branch. Today's my topic is about survey of wild animals at past 10 years. Wildlife benefits are determined by the surveys of the both specific species of the interest and the general indicator species, which include those that may be number of economic interested but whose population indicate a healthy habit. The four general approaches are incomplete count and indirect count mark recapture method. A complete count or a total counts every member of population, distance between member of derived crew or critical of a success. All deer must be connected even those heading and Incomplete count involves counting and incomplete count involves counting part of a population that exploding to all entire population predators may be unpublished in sample areas and an attempt made to count all individuals in each predator. The population of tiger in India are on 2006 is 1,411. In 2020 is nearly 3,500 tigers. Lion population in India on 1990 is nearly 284 lions. In 2020 there are 674 lions in India. Wildlife is a term that refers to animals that are not normally domesticated. They are living resources that will die and be replaced by the other of their kind. Wildlife plays an important role in balancing the environment and provides the ability stability to different nature processes. It can be found in all ecosystems, desert, rainforest, plains, and other areas. India's wildlife is both rich and varied. It includes all flora and fauna, animals, plants, and microorganisms. Thank you. Over to my friend Pooja Vasudevan.
Thank you, Anagilan, for sharing the valuable information. I'm Pooja Vasudevan, once again here to share some information and ideas in which you can save wild animals. Humans and other factors of the environment cause great danger to the lives of these animals. But that's not the end of the world for wild animals. We humans can make some small changes in our life, which would make a big difference, such as raising awareness and spreading the word among friends, family members and school community about the value and importance of wildlife and wild habitats, which will provide easy access to the knowledge that is very vital to the well-being of our land and waters. Conserving energy. We should use less electricity and turn off and on the lights only when it's necessary and turning down the thermostat. We should encourage school administrators and parents at home to use energy-efficient appliances. Tree plantation and planting of trees. Planting a native tree in your backyard or in your schoolyard can absorb carbon dioxide from the atmosphere, which will be better for the habitats of wild animals as well as for humans. Role of young generation. Catch them young. As the saying goes, kids of today should be exposed to various activities of wildlife, education, and wildlife conservation. The youngsters should learn and be trained to impart knowledge about the variety and value of wildlife. Community participation. Encourage community participation in management and conservation of wildlife and protected areas. Discouraging animal products. Using wildlife products like shawls, ashtray, frame brushes, leather products, etc. creates a market for them, in which in turn becomes an established business, which influences more such activities, which is not good. Getting involved. We can volunteer and join at various campaigns and donate money for activities related to wildlife conservation. Or you can visit websites like WWF.org, WCS.org, Greenpeace.org, and many others which offer to raise funds for saving wildlife. Reducing, reusing, and recycling. It takes less energy to create products from recycled goods than from raw materials. Encourage yourself and others to reduce the usage of cars. Give objects a second life by reusing them instead of throwing them in the garbage. By following these steps, we will have a positive effect on our environment. Adopting wild animals. You can adopt one of these wild animals, which help fight many of the threats to their natural environment. The funds raised through these adoptions are used to help save wild animals in the wild. And while you're adopting your wild animal, you also get the chance to become more close with it and learn more about the species. Avoiding plastic. Plastic pollution has a direct and deadly effect on wildlife. Thousands of seabirds and sea turtles, seals, and other marine animals are affected. According to UNESCO, over 1 million marine animals, including mammals, fishes, sharks, turtles, and birds, are killed each year due to plastic debris in the ocean. And it has been reported that many cows have almost died because of ingesting plastic. So try your best to not buy plastic products and stop the usage of single-use plastic. Becoming vegetarianism. Becoming vegetarian. Vegetarianism. This is a term used to convey the practice of abstaining from the consumption of meat. This may also include abstention from byproducts of animals. This is both a healthy and a useful habit for conserving wildlife forms. Many delicacies and recipes are based on local insects, reptiles, and birds, which have a major impact on wildlife and such the whole environment. Many species are facing endangerment because of their human taste for flesh. Therefore, you can reduce the amount of meat and animals products you buy and consume. So these are some of the ways in which you can save wild animals. And thank you for your attention. Over on to my friend Sujan Ram.
Thank you, Pooja Vasudevan. Hi, everybody. I'm Sujan Ram from Madurai branch. Today, I'm going to say about my responsibility on wild animals. Kindness and justice to animal is an essential part of a human virtue. They show kindness because they are helpless and cannot pay their own cost. Cruelty to animals is often due to the thoughtlessness and lack of imagination. The animals that live in the world have an intrinsic value and contribute to the ecological, genetic, social, economic, scientific, educational, cultural, recreational, and aesthetic aspects of human well-being and to sustainable development. Wild animal is a term that refers to animals that are not normally domesticated. Wild animals generally live in forests. Wild animals help to maintain the ecological balance of nature and maintain the food chain. It provides useful substances and wild animal products like ivory, leather, honey, dust, etc. Besides being a country's cultural asset, it also provides aesthetic value to man. We largely depend on wild animals for every elementary requirement in our life. Example, the cloth we wear and the medicine we consume. Wildlife conservation encompasses all human activities and efforts directed to protect the wild animal from extinction. It involves both protection and scientific management of wild species. Wildlife and nature have largely been associated with humans for numerous emotional and for social reasons. Wildlife plays an essential role in the ecological and biological processes that are yet again significant to life. The normal functioning of the biosphere depends on the interaction among animals, plants, and microorganisms. Wildlife has occupied a special place of veneration and preservation in various cultures of the world. What is your responsibility in saving wild animals? Yes, I also have a point to share with you. Save animals play a key role in our life. So I have a responsibility to save wild animals. I assure that I insist my friend to save wild animals by not cut down the trees. Save wild animals, save there. My friend Layani is here to share some point to save wild animals.
My responsibility is I will visit a national park to support wildlife economy, promote sustainable tourism, and I will also use my power of my network to tell others in social media about saving wild animals.
Thank you, Nayalini. Divyalakshmi, what is your responsibility to saving wild animals?
My responsibility towards wild animals. I will tell to my friends and families to plant native species of flowers, trees, and bushes in your yard. This gives wild animals food, shelter, and a place to raise families.
Thank you, Divyalakshmi. What is your responsibility in saving wild animals, Anagilan?
My responsibility is to save wild animals. Is visit a nearby zoo and sanctuary and provide small funds to save animals in zoo. I will ask my friends to join in this revolution. Thank you.
Thank you, Anagilan. Akshaya, what is your responsibility to save wild animals?
My responsibility to taking awareness and sharing this information by visiting my Facebook friends.
Thank you, Akshaya. Saifi Hussain, what is your responsibility for saving wild animals?
My responsibility is when we conserve and protect our natural habitat of wild species, we enrich our planet. To do, we must keep the animals in natural place. Thank you.
Thank you, Saifi. Lastly, Pooja, what is your responsibility in saving wild animals?
My responsibility is that I would avoid buying products which are made of animals and I try my best to buy sustainable and plastic-free products which will help save our environment and wild animals.
Thank you, Pooja. Thank you, everyone, to say a valuable word to save wild animals. Let me conclude, the cruelty to animals is much more than cruelty to men because animals are helpless and them. Educating the public is an effective method to avoid such atrocities. The aim of education should be cultivate a spirit of compassion among the public towards our dumb benefactor. Thank you everyone to give me and my friends to talk about this particular topic. Save animals, save where. Take.
Thank you, my dear students. It was a wonderful thoughts and ideas you shared. Over to Surendraji.
Yeah, that was a good presentation, Team Wild Animal. Let us start with domestic animal. Over to Inda.
Very good morning, team. Thank you. Happy to know that at this young age, you are taking responsibility towards safeguarding our environment. Okay, and I have a team of 8 students who are going to present about the domestic animals. Share few information about domestic animals and how to conserve these domestic animals. And over to Anita Bishnoi.
Thank you, ma'am. A very good morning to one and all present here. I'm Anita Bishnoi of class 7 and today I'm here in the creative team with something really interesting and amazing topic. And our favorite, domestic animals. I want to introduce me and my team to also say some crazy and interesting facts about domestic animals. Before starting, let me give a small acknowledgement to the authorities who helped me and my team in this wonderful presentation. The PowerPoint presentation is a part of collaborative work of 8 members of our team, the soft skill trainer who supported us and collaborated with our project. I give a special thanks to our soft skill trainer, Indra ma'am. Shortly, let me also introduce my teammates, the 8 members in our team, Anita, myself, Hasini, Ananya, Harshal, Niranjani, Sachin, Praveen, Nivedita, and me. Now, are you all excited? Let's get started. In this session, we are going to know what are domestic animals, what are types of domestic animals, where are they found, what are benefits of a domestic animal, what are responsibilities towards our domestic animals. So, let's get started. Domestic animals are animals that have been tamed and kept by humans as work animals, source of food, or pet. There are different kinds of domestic animals. The cow, dog, sheep, lambs are some of the examples of domestic animals. Domestic animals are very useful and faithful to us, and they are human friendly too. Well, now it's time to know some crazy facts about domestic animals. Do you all know goats and sheep do not have their teeth on their upper jaw? Goat is believed the first ever animal to be domesticated. Pig can run up to 11 miles in an hour. Ducks have waterproof feathers. Elephant is the only animal that cannot jump. Slug have 4 noses to smell. Snail can sleep up to 3 years. Sheep have 2 toes in their feet. And the last fact, a goat is the one of the cleanest animal among all the domestic animals. I hope you all enjoyed my fact and few of the facts you have never heard. Now, I would like to leave the session to my friend Hasini.
Thank you, Anita. Good morning, everyone. I am Hasini from Chennai MR Nagar branch. Today, I am going to speak about types of domestic animals and brief note on farm animals. Types of domestic animals. Archaeology has identified the 3 classes of animal domesticates: pets, livestock, beasts of burden. Pet animal is a domesticated animal which live with people and not forced to do any work or not eaten in most of instances. Example, dogs, cats, hamsters, etc. Livestock animals is commonly defined as domesticated animal which is used for agricultural settings. Example, goat, cattle, sheep, pigs, etc. Beasts of burden is a domesticated animal which is trained for carrying goods and people. Example, horses, camels, donkeys, etc. Also, there are many types of aquatic animals which live in water and depend for their survival. They play an important role and provide food, energy, and even jobs. Example, fish, mammals, sea snails, jellyfish, and crabs. Brief note on farm animals. Farm animals are kept in farm for a variety of reasons. These include the domesticated animal, which is raised in confinement, including mink and fish. Classes of farm animals. There are 3 classes of farm animals based on their digestive system. Monogastric, ruminant, and pseudo-ruminant animals. Monogastric animals have simple stomach. These include all poultry species, rabbits, donkeys, horses, etc. Ruminant animals eat plants and they have 4 compartments of stomach. These include cattle, sheep, goat, etc. Pseudo-ruminant animals eat lots of roughage, but they have only 3 compartments of stomach. These include camels, alpacas, etc. There are many reasons attributed to raise in the farm animals. These include milk production, meat production, egg production, companionship, and income generation. The United Nations of Food and Agricultural Organization has identified the 8,800 breeds of domestic animals within 38 domesticated species. Thank you. On to you, Ananya.
Thank you, Hasini. Hello friends, I am Ananya Kiran of class 7. Now we are going to learn types of domestic animal and briefly on birds and poultry animals. So let's know, what is poultry? poultry are domesticated avians that can be raised by humans for their eggs, meats, and feathers. The term poultry covers a wide range of birds, from indigenous and commercial breeds of hens, ducks, turkeys, geese, and so on, for the purpose of eggs and meat for our consumption. Now let's know about chicken. As the best known backyard farm bird, chickens are valued because they are easy keepers and quite useful. Each breed is noted for its ability, looks, and other individual characteristics. Commercial growers, chicken breeds that can produce either meat or egg quickly and economically. So let's know about waterfowls. Waterfowls birds like geese and ducks will choose to live in or around ponds or other water sources. Both are raised for meat, feathers, and dons. They are also termed as scavengers and also play an important role in ecosystem. Each duck production makes good use of available labor in rural area and increase the income of poor farmer, especially the landless. Now let's know about turkey. Turkey originate from Mexico and Central America. Turkey eat about 1/2 pound of feed a day. It is used for both egg and meat purpose. Now let's know what is ratites. Ratites are large exotic birds raised mainly for their meat and feathers. They produce lean red meat and skin that serves as leather to make coat, purse, and shoes. The South American rhea, emu from Australia, and African ostrich are types of ratites farmed around the world. Now let's know about pet birds. Pet birds like parakeets, parrots, and cockatiels, etc. are very rewarding pet to the right owner due to their intelligence and desire to interact with people. Many parrots are very affectionate, even cuddly with trusted people, and require a lot of attention from their owners consistently. Thank you. Now my friend Harshil is going to explain you all about endangered domestic animal. Upon to you, Harshil.
Thank you, Ananya. A very good morning to everyone present here. I am Harshil from Chennai Ramapuram branch, here to talk about endangered domestic animals. But before we see what are endangered domestic animals, let's first understand what are endangered animals and the different types of endangerment. Endangered animals. Endangered animals are animals that are at a very high risk of becoming extinct. For example, the Bengal tiger and the Indian elephant. Critically endangered animals. Critically endangered animals are animals that are on the brink of extinction. For example, the hornbill and the gharial. Vulnerable animals. Vulnerable animals are animals that are at a very high risk of human-caused extinction if conservationists don't intervene. For example, cheetah and lion. Near threatened. Animals that fall into the near threatened category are not qualified as critically endangered, endangered, or vulnerable, but the scientists believe they will reach one of these levels in the near future. Least concern. Animals that fall into the least concern category are not currently facing any habitat or population decline. Extinct animals. Extinct animals are animals that no longer exist in the world. For example, the saber-toothed tiger. Now that we've understood what are endangered animals, let's understand why these animals become endangered. The most important reasons these animals become endangered are geographic changes. With development and deforestation, native animals are destroyed to bring in changes. Population reduction. With geographic changes and natural calamities, animal population becomes a threat. Crossbreeding. Crossbreeding is a process by taking two breeds and breeding them to make a hybrid breed, but this diminishes the quality of the original breed. Less male to female ratio. With population reduction and crossbreeding, there's a less male to female ratio, which results in a species becoming endangered. Now, these were some of the animals that were there 50 years ago. Cows like Red Sindhi, Thar Parker, goats like St. Croix, Assam Hill, hens like Siruvidai, Telicheri, horses like Manipuri Pony and Sikang. But currently, almost all of these animals are critically endangered, endangered, or vulnerable. Now, let's see the impacts of losing these animal breeds. The most important impacts of losing these animal breeds are food adulteration. Food adulteration means that we will not get the natural milk or meat produced from these animals. Artificial products. Artificial products means that we will not get the natural woolen produced from these animals. ecological imbalance. Humans and animals need to coexist for a balanced ecosystem, but losing these breeds will result in an imbalanced ecosystem. Medical studies or research and development. We use animals for research and development, but losing these breeds will result in a loss of knowledge as well as different types of developments, which leads to medicines. Now, let's see how we can conserve these endangered species. The best way to conserve these endangered species are an individual should take responsibility and not do crossbreeding and also provide a natural habitat for their survival. Government should also enforce strict laws to punish anybody who encourages harm to these endangered species. Thank you all for listening to me. And now on to my friend Niranjani.
Thank you, Hasin. Good morning to all. I am Niranjani from Vasara Vakambran. Here I am going to talk about benefits of domestic animals to humans and how they balance the ecosystem. First, we'll see about benefits of domestic animals to humans. Benefits of domestic animals to humans are classified into three types. They are food-giving animals, drug-giving animals, and transproducing animals. What are food-giving animals? The animals which give us food is known as food-giving animals. For example, hen. Hen gives us eggs and meat and it helps to lose weight. Goat. Goat gives us milk and meat and goat is one of the earliest superfood and goat milk can contribute to brain development also. Cow. Cow gives us meat. From meat we make curd, butter, ghee and pockets. From pockets we make variety of delicious meat. Next we'll see about frog-giving animals. What is the example of frog-giving animals? That is sheep. Let's see about the benefits of sheep. They provide meat, wool, byproducts, ecosystem service, and so on. From the fur of the sheep, the fur is here and made into wool, which is used by the human. Next, we'll see about transproducing animals. What are transproducing animals? The animals which is used to transport the goods or grains from one place to other places known as transproducing animals. For example, ox. Is used to transport the grains or goods and often are used as skin. And often may be used as for riding. Donkeys are used to carry heavy loads and goods and it is used in many places in India. Next we'll see about how they balance the ecosystem. What is an ecosystem? Ecosystem is the community of living organisms interacting with each other and then surrounding environment. How they balance the ecosystem? So, they are seen to be an ecological balance between animals in nature. Some of the animals help to bring out their nutrition from cycle, while others help in decomposition, carbon and nitrogen cycle. Domestic animals, insects and even microorganisms play a role in ecosystem. Thank you. Over on to my friend Sachin.
Thank you, Niranjani. Good morning to all of my dear friends and to the respectable teachers. My name is Sachin, studying in class 7 from Ramapuram branch. Today, I'm going to talk about the topic called the surveys and schemes taken by the government and non-government in conserving domestic animals. Before I go into the topic, do you know why we need animals in our country? We need animals in our country because the animals bring proud honor and compassion to our country, India. Now let's get into the topic. The laws and orders taken by the government and non-government in conserving domestic animals. We in India should be proud as the citizens of India. It is because the Constitution of India has taken many efforts in conserving the domestic animals. The animals are also considered as the pride of India. According to the Article 51, it has been said that it is the duty of every citizen of India to respect the Constitution and abide by its laws and regulations, mainly to protect the animals. Next, let's learn about the schemes taken by the government and non-government in domestic animals. That scheme is known as the animal husbandry. Do you know what is meant by animal husbandry? Animal husbandry is nothing but It is a branch of science which helps in taking care of the cattle, dogs, horses, cows, etc., especially by the humans. This scheme of animal husbandry has been started at the Stone Age period, which also called as the Neolithic Revolution, around 13,000 BC years ago. Next, let's learn about the two main extinct animals. The first is the mammoth. The mammoth is nothing but is the extinct species of the elephant family. Its scientific name is the Mammothus primigenius. It is largely equipped with large tusk, covered long hair and large and white feet, which protect it from the extreme cold condition. This is because there's a random climatic condition in the Stone Age period. Next is the Atlantic gray whale. The Atlantic gray whale is also called as the Californian whale, or the black whale is a baleen whale. It is about 49 meters and 41 tons weight. It has been mainly extinct due to the water pollution in many countries or in oceans. Next, let's get into the comparison of the surveys. In the year 1960, it has been recorded that there's a 68% decrease in domestic animals in a country, India. The same has been recorded in the year 2016. But in the year 2020, there's a high risk of the domestic animals in a country, India. There's an average of 98% of decrease and 88% decrease of the animals in a country, India. Now let's see about the number of endangered species of animals of the rising. From the year 2007 to the year 2019, there is a number of population of the endangered species rising until the Constitution of India has taken much efforts, but there is no decreasing order. Now I am ending my speech by giving a special thanks to all the soft skills trainer. Now on to my friend Praveen, who is going to say about the awareness on domestic animals. Thank you and have a nice day.
Thank you, Sachin. My name is Ketan Kumar. I'm going to talk about awareness on domestic animals. Provide exercise for your dog. Dog needs walking, running, digging, and exploring. Keep cat indoors. Indoor cats live longer, safer than their lives. Choose organic grass, fed beef, cows, calves, pigs, chickens, turkey, ducks, geese, and other animals. Have kept in a small cages in jam-packed sheds or on a filthy feedlot, often with so little space there that they can't even turn around or lie down comfortably. They are deprived of exercise of all their body's energy, goes towards the producing of flesh, eggs, or milk for a human consumption. Choose a non-animal fabric. Avoid eel skin, ivory, pearls, feathers, wool, angora. Choose an insect cotton, nylon, rayon, pearls, rubber, etc. Do not buy products that contain animal ingredients. Animal and animal deprived ingredients are incorporated in seemingly innocuous products. Keep their doors. Hundreds of species of birds and animals live in a dead tree and feed on the insects. They top off rather than chop down a dead tree. Support the connection. A child born with a companion animal builds a social competency, social density, interpersonal trust, and empathy, all necessary qualities to building an emotional and intelligent compassion. Thank you. Now I over to my friend Nivedita.
Thank you, Praveen. Wonderful morning to one and all present here. This is Nivedita of class 7 from Ramapuram branch, here to talk about ways to conserve domestic animals. So what is animal conservation? Animal conservation is a practice of protecting animal species and their habitat. It is achieved partially through legislation such as Endangered Species Act, establishment and protection of public lands, and responsible public practices can conserve animal population. Now, let's quickly move on to ways to conserve domestic animals. Buy responsibly by not purchasing products made from endangered animal or their parts. You can stop animal trafficking by being a profitable enterprise. Pigeon. Trash isn't ugly. It's harmful. Birds and other animals can trap their heads into plastic rings. Fish can get stuck in nets. Plus, trash pollutes everyone's natural resources. Restore. Habitat destruction is the main threat for 85% of animal species. You can reduce the threat by planting native trees, restoring wetlands, or cleaning up beaches in your area. Speak up. Share your passion for conserving wildlife with your family and tell your friends how they can help. You can even create a blog where you can put your ideas in conserving domestic animals. Donate. When you visit local zoos or nature reserve, pay the recommended entry fee. Your donations may help maintain these vital conservation areas. Don't harass or kill wildlife. Don't injure, hunt, shoot, or capture a wildlife. Restore, recycle, and reduce. Uses of carbon footprint, use of energy, and use of natural resources by buying and consuming less, using and recycling more. Stop selfies. Sadly, this has led to the explosion of sloths, pink river dolphins, camines, anacondas, and many more animals. Now you might know the important facts about domestic animals, brief on farm animals, poultry animals, birds, and endangered domestic animals, benefits of domestic animals and how they balance the ecosystem, surveys and schemes in last 5 years, awareness and ways to conserve domestic animals. Anita, do you want to say anything?
Yes, Nivedita. I just remembered a quote at this point of time, said by Andre D. Williams. Humanity can save animals or weaken them to die. We have power to decide. Now it's our choice. I think only if we understand, we can care. Only if we care, we can help. And only if we help, we can save our precious domestic animals.
Yeah, it's true. So I conclude as, in order to have a satisfactory relationship between society and its environment, all the discussed ideas should be executed effectively. So the future generations may have an opportunity to experience nature to its fullest extent. Save Earth, save wildlife. Thank you and have a wonderful day.
Thank you so much, children. It was a good presentation. Great indeed. And request all the future generation to keep these points in mind in conserving our nature and the wildlife and conservation of domestic animals as well. So thank you so much and on to Surendra.
Thank you, Team Domestic Animals. Next, we'll start with pet animals. We have a team of 8 students going to present on pet animals. Let's start with Vaishnavi.
Thank you, sir. Good morning and a warm welcome to everyone. Also, I would like to thank you for this great big opportunity. Using this opportunity, we, the pet animal team, are here with few points. Now, let's have a quick look at the overview of our team. Myself, Vaishnavi from Chennai GPM. I will be giving the introduction and facts. Santosh will be saying about the types of pet animals, followed by Janet will be discussing the types of ancient pet animals. Next, why people choose pet animals will be said by my friend Punya. What other animals human can adopt will be suggested by Srivarshini. Benefits of pet animals will be explained by Mridula. Types of food for pets will be suggested by Kritika. My responsibility in safeguarding these pet animals will be explained by Pritika. Now, let's go to my topic, what is a pet animal and why they are called pet animals. What is a pet animal? An animal that can live with us, interact with us, depends on us for their basic needs. Sometimes they don't work at all. That is what pet animals are. Sometimes animals are taken to the animal shelter as few people are not willing to adopt the pets on the streets. The old and sick animals are given to the veterinary and taken to the animal shelter. Why they are called pet animals, you ask me? Let me tell you. We see lots of animals around us, don't we? But why do we specifically call them as pet animals? The word pet comes from the Scottish word piata, meaning tame animal. This word seemed to have evolving for a long time in the Scottish language, signifying an animal of companionship. You know, the dogs are an expert in safeguarding their owners and their family. Did you also know that some people adopt wild animals as pets? But the owner of these wild pet animals must be an animal expert, must have the capability to handle them, as wild animals are dangerous. Mainly, the environment must be proper for the wild animals. Here are a few famous people who adopt wild animals as pets. First, we have Carson, a 10-year-old boy who loves to live with snakes. Next, we have Shandor, an animal trainer and a safari park keeper. In his safari park, he grows lions. Simon and Jim, who live at the Animal Orphan Center. They grow the world's most dangerous bear, the grizzly bear. Thank you. Over to my friend Santosh on the topic types of pet animals. Please proceed, Santosh.
Thank you, Vaishnavi. So, hi, everyone. I'm Santosh Balaji. I'm from Ramapuram. So, today my topic is types of pet animals. The types of pet animals are dog, cat, fish, bird, horse, and rabbit. Dog. Types of dog. Hound dog, police dog, and military dog. Hound dogs are useful for hunting. Top 5 dog-friendly countries are France, Switzerland, Italy, Canada, and Great Britain. Pet dogs are very loyal to their owners and show the love for their masters without any expectation. Scientific name, Canis lupus familiaris. Cat. Top 5 cat-friendly countries are Italy, United Kingdom, Netherlands, and United States. Cats are so good at keeping themselves clean. Hence, people love to have them as pets. Scientific name, Felis catus. Fish. Top 5 fish-friendly countries are United States, France, Brazil, Australia, and United Kingdom. Common aquarium fishes are flower rock, wooden fish, and angel fish. People grow fishes for luck as well. That is called Arowana. Scientific name, Ostichius. Bird. Top 5 bird-friendly countries are Colombia, Peru, Brazil, Indonesia, and Ecuador. Top types of pet birds are parrots, finches, lovebirds, and cockatiel and cockatoos. Scientific name, Aves. Horse. Top 5 horse-friendly countries are United States, Mexico, China, Brazil, and Argentina. Plus was King Alexander's horse, and one of the most famous horses in the world history. Scientific name, Equus caballus. Rabbit. Top 3 rabbit-friendly countries are China, Tajikistan, Italy, etc. Top types of pet rabbits are Auckland rabbit, Rex rabbit, Jersey woolly rabbit, Dutch rabbit, Nilgiri rabbit, Chinchilla rabbit, Polish rabbit, Lion-eared rabbit, Californian rabbit, and Himalayan rabbit. Scientific name, Articulus cuniculus. Pet ownership. If you see in the pet ownership pie chart, dogs played a major role. Dogs are 55%, cats are 30%, and the other are in the minimum count. Thanks all for listening. Over to my friend Janet on Asian pet animals.
Thank you, Santosh. Good evening, everyone. My name is Janet Fudos. I'm from World Expo CHWTR. Today, I'm going to talk about all types of Asian pet animals. The two most popular pet is dog and cat. In ancient Egypt, during the days of pharaohs, dogs were considered to be scared. Dogs have played an important role for a history of human civilization and were among the first domesticated animals. They were so important in hunter-gatherer societies as a hunting ally and a bodyguard against predators. Ancient Egypt worshipped many animals for thousands of years. Animals were referred for different reasons. Dogs were valued for their ability to protect and hunt, but cats were thought to be more special. Egyptians believed cats were magic creatures capable of bringing them good luck to the people who housed them. In ancient times, the turtles were used as pet mainly fishermen. When the fisherman lost his way in the sea, the turtle knew the way for his owner's home. The pigeons were used for sending messages, not only in ancient times, but recently as early in the 90s during the World War I. A particular breed of pigeons called humming pigeons. Over to my friend Punya. Why do people choose pet animals? Thank you, everyone.
Thank you, Janet. This is Punya of class 7 to give a speech about why people choose pet animals. Why people choose pet animals? Pets are known to reduce stress and anxiety levels. Experts say that people can get relief from stress and depression if they spend time with their pets. Ours is a pet-loving culture. Researchers spend a lot of time exploring what has become known as the human-animal interaction, and the pet industry spends a lot of money promoting what it refers to call the human-animal bond. Reasons for why we should have a pet at home. Pets can enhance your mood, help you to control your blood pressure. Your pet is your friend, a dosage of entertainment. These real stress buster. They build responsibility within you, and etc. Safety measures. Children are 5 years of age and younger, people with weak immune system, and people 65 years of age and older are more likely to get diseases spread between animals and people, also known as zoonotic diseases. Pregnant women are also at a higher risk for certain animal-related diseases. Benefits of having a pet. There are many health benefits of owning a pet. They can increase opportunities to get exercise, get outside, and socialize. Regular walking or playing with pets can increase, decrease blood pressure, cholesterol level, etc. Pets can help manage loneliness and depression by giving us companionship. How to keep your pets healthy? Regular veterinarian visit is required for your pet's health. Interact with your veterinarian on keeping your pets healthy. Provide your pets with a good diet, fresh water, clean bedding, and plenty of exercises. How to keep yourself healthy? Whether you are playing with, feeding, or cleaning up after your pets, it is important to wash your hands to help reduce the risk of getting sick from germs that pets can carry. Vaccines for your pets. Vaccination is a safe and effective way to prevent diseases. Today, vaccines are available to protect against at least 20 diseases. I thank my teachers for giving me the great opportunity. Over to my friend Sri Vashini. What are the other animals that humans can adopt? Thank you.
Thank you, Punya. Hi, everyone. I am Sri Vashini from OMR branch. Today, my topic is on pet animals. Pet animals add joy and happiness to our life or home. Having a friendly pet at home causes you to remain healthy and happy. This in turn reduces you from unnecessary stress and attention. Let us see what are all the other animals humans can adopt. They are small rodents, ferrets, rabbits, iguanas and red ear sliders. Let us see about the first one, small rodents. They are the small pocket pets and they are not very difficult to care for in terms of keeping them alive. Let us see. Why should you adopt a small rodent? Small rodents belong to the rat family and they are used for food, laboratory and animal in research. And they are found in all continents except Antarctica. Let us see about the next animal, ferrets. Most ferrets that you see being sold in pet stores comes from Marshall Farm, the commercial breeder of dogs and ferrets for pet and scientific research. Let us see why should you adopt a ferret. Ferrets are used for controlling rabbits and rats and they are available in Europe and Australia and they are used for medical research and formerly for the trade. Let us see about the next one, rabbits. Rabbit is a wonderful and pretty pet animal, right? Yes, it is. Let us see about the rabbit. Rabbits reproduce like wild rabbits and they are often bought for children like other small pets. An unfortunate trend involves them being sold in pet stores comes from the addition to the Easter baskets. Let us see why should you adopt a rabbit. Let us see. Rabbits are used for food, wool, fur trade, and the production industries have developed domesticated rabbits breeds to efficiently fill these needs. And they are the most common laboratory animal. Let us see about the next one, iguanas. It looks like harm, right? But it is also a good pet animal. Let us see about it. Green iguanas are in a crisis situation as pets in the United States. Sold as small, cute, and innocuous juveniles. Let us see. Why should you adopt an iguanas? Iguanas can grow quite large and they are very strong and they can live for more than 50 years. Let us see about the next one, red ear sliders. Red ear sliders. It looks like a turtle, right? Yes, it belongs to the turtle family. And red ear sliders are the most throwaway pets and that are sold in stores and do not expect more high maintenance pet. And let us see, why should you adopt red ear sliders? Yes, let us see. They are the most popular semi-aquatic turtle in the United States and they have length 50 to 30 centimeters and they are different from compared to other pet animals. Let us see. Let me conclude my speech with comparison ratio between last 5 years. In this picture, you can see that 44% of people have chosen the iguanas and 26% of people have chosen the red ear sliders. Remaining are as follows. Let us see. I suggest you people to adopt these animals as pets. Stay happy and healthy. Let me over this video.
Thank you, Sri Vashini. Good morning, everyone. My name is Timurla. I'm studying France Primary Section. I'm from Navayana Eternal School, Chennai region. I'm going to talk about benefits of pet animals to humans. There are many health benefits of owning a pet animal. They can increase opportunities to get exercise outside and socialize. Regular walking or playing with pets can decrease blood pressure, cholesterol level, etc. Pets can manage roller's depression by giving us companionship. Pets can increase fitness, low stress, pain, happiness to their owners. As it goes to cats, cats are intelligent and popular pet in the world. These fluffy little cuddles are amazing house pets. They can lower risk of heart disease. Cat owners know how one session of petting or playing with a cat can turn a bad day into a good day. Cats also help when we are loneliness. They fulfill our needs of companionship. That goes to dogs. Dogs make us feel less alone. They are good for your heart. They help you stop stressing out. They help to cope with cuddles. They innovate you to move. They make us more social. They are so adorable. They make you love them and make us happier. That goes to birds. Most companion birds like parrot have very long lifespan as compared to other birds. This means that you won't need to deal with the grief of losing your friend to old age. Recent studies have shown that keeping a bird encourages social education, which is good for your mental heart. Any pet encourages empathy in children. A pet that you can really talk to and who clearly understand what you're feeling. If it goes to hamster, they are affordable and expensive to feed. They have simple and expensive habitat needs. They do not take up a lot of space. They do not require much social invitation. They have no special grooming and no special training. Now over to my friend Kritika about pet and its food. Thank you.
Thank you, Mridula, for giving the wonderful speech. Have a wonderful morning to everybody. I'm VP Kritika, 7th standard from Pullal branch. I'm going to discuss about pet animals and their food types. Introductions. Pets are part of everyday lives and a part of our families. They provide us with companionship, but also with emotional support, reduce our stress levels and loneliness, and help us to increase our social activities and to child self-esteem and a positive emotional development. Animals is our sources to living wood. Farmers rise to catch lamb, sheep, goat and other animals simply to make a living by selling milk, meat, etc. Fishing, rearing of the employment for the humans. Hard serve is used to the drawn cats. Pet animals and their food. Pets food is a plant of the animal material intended for consumption by pets. Typically sold in the pet store and the supermarket. It is usually specific to types of the animal, the dog for the cat food. Most breeds of the human is the industry and it's not a garden and human's grade. Dog, it is entirely acceptable to feed your dog. It's a pure carnivore diet. Or you can mix and meat, fish, vegetable and rice. Many own words have to feed a raw meat and a diet day. Dog and while this cat feed some the dogs are unique to be a work. Cat are a meat eaten, so plain and simple. They have to have protein from a meat for a healthy reproduction system. Cooked beef and chicken, turkey, and a small amount of the lean, deaf meat. Of the great way to give make your cat sick. Cow and sheep. 90% of the food they eat a pasture are hay. Crably, the most of the in generally goats love to eat a pasture, rations, grains, chaff, eat, sunflower, figs, carrots, and pumpkin seeds. For this specific like a black and Bengal are entirely found in the jackfruit leaves. More than the 50% of the cow feed is actually grass. Farmers call it a hay and a silage. While people often think daily crow and the grains diet, reality and the leaf stems are corn, wheat, kind of oats, more than they are eating the grains and the corn millets. Birds, parrots are the omnivores, which means that they can eat both meat and vegetation. Most parrots are eat the seeds and the insects. Seeds are their favorite food. They out or nut cells and get the seeds that are inside. Raw or steamed, preferably organic, will available. Cooked are the pseudo grains such as rice bran, while forbidden oats, barley, buckwheat, amaranth, and stiffer. Soaked are the sprouted lemons. Raw soaked are sprouted nuts and the seeds. Hamster, commercial hamster, not a music style. Mitsa. You can buy this at a pet shop or a observation treats like a nuts, boiled eggs, and a meat will. Apples, no seeds, banana, blueberry, broccoli, carrot, cauliflower, and cucumber. Rabbit. Rabbits love their food and enjoy the fresh fruits and vegetables. As a part of the everything, rabbits, an unlimited amount of the fresh air we timely order. Meadows, hay, grass, and the plenty of the clean water available. Hey. Fresh air must be make up the bulk of your rabbit diet and needs to are really available to all the times. An adult rabbit can eat a regular while younger rabbit should not be given a higher protein and sugar content. Thank you to all for watching my speech. Once again, thank you to all. After my speech, I'm passing to my friend Prithika. My friend topic is my responsibility of safeguarding these pet animals. All the best, Prithika.
Thank you, Kritika, for your wonderful explanation. Good morning to one and all present here. I am Kritika from Pulai Branch. I am here to discuss about the topic, my responsibility in safeguarding these pet animals. In today's lifestyle, I think this is one of the most important topics to be discussed. I hope you all do think so. All the animals in the world are useful to mankind in balancing the ecosystem, especially the pet animals are very helpful to humans in many ways. Among all the living beings in the world, as humans are the most advanced living being, the responsibility in maintaining the ecosystem through safeguarding all the other living things totally lies on them. All the living things in the world have their own basic needs. Humans need food, shelter, clothing, health and hygiene. Likewise, pet animals also have their own basic needs of food, shelter, providing hygiene, proper love, care and affection. It is our main duty and responsibility to provide them all these basic needs. The main responsibilities of a pet owner are as follows. Giving them regular exercise. Some pets need regular exercise. For example, dogs require plenty of outdoor exercise while cats prefer chasing and swatting at cat toys. Scheduling annual checkup. Taking the pets for an annual wellness checkup to a veterinary doctor keeps them healthy, find their health problems before falling sick and provide vaccines at the right time. Feed them properly. Providing the pet with proper healthy food is the best level of showing absolute care to them. Keeping the pet safe. Providing a separate room for them to roam and play around and to safeguard them from other infectious animals and also from running out of the house. The month of February celebrated as Pet Ownership Month. Pets are not only animals but also a member of our family. They have to have the right to live without pain. There is also an urgent need to make strict laws for cruelty against animals at the hands of humans. Every year, millions of animals are killed in India either to feed the non-vegetarian population or in laboratories for medical experiments. Cruelty against animals is a clearly identified offense under Section 428 and Section 429 of the Indian Penal Code. Reports of cruelty must be taken seriously. Banners and posters should be put up at all major areas of the town to spread awareness among general public about being kindful to animals. Many organizations like SPCA, Society for the Prevention of Cruelty to Animals, PEDA, People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, and PAWS, Pet Animal Welfare Society, are working very hard to save the rights of the pet animals, to safeguard them from being harassed and to provide their basic needs also. Animal cruelty can also be complained through the emergency number 98201-22602. I repeat, 98201-22602. It is also the duty of the parents to teach the children, the future generation of the world, to protect the environment and ecosystem through safeguarding all the animals and providing all rights for them to live on the earth equally to humans. I conclude my discussion with this. I hope all of my friends above have given you a clear-cut explanation about the pet animals, their food, living habits, and their usefulness to humans. From all this, we can clearly understand that it is the duty of all of us to join hands and take a pledge in safeguarding the animals and safeguarding our environment by doing so. Thank you to Narayana Institution for giving me this wonderful opportunity for presenting the speech in front of the judges, parents, teachers, and all of my friends. Thank you once again to one and all.
Thank you, Team Pet Animals. Good presentation. Now, we'll conclude with extinct animal. Over to Madhumita.
Thank you, Surendra. That was a wonderful and informative performance from the previous team, domestic pet and wild animals. It is the responsibility of each and every citizen to save this species from extinction. Having said that, I would like to call upon the team Extinct Animal to give the presentation. Over to Janani.
Good morning to one and all present here. I'm here, Janani, from Pallavaram.
Today, I'm going to talk about my social responsibility. In that, I will talk about extinct animals. Our team will give a presentation about extinct animals. Now, I introduce my team. Myself, Janani. I will introduce. Next, Shanmita will talk about list of extinct animals. And Kavya will talk about animals in endangered to be extinct. Tanushi and Diya will talk about reason for extinction. And Devasamuthan will give how to prevent extinction. Mahati will talk about consequences of extinction. And Afros will talk about how to conserve animal lives. Finally, Devasamuthan will give a conclusion. Now, I will give a small introduction about extinct animals. What is extinction? Extinction is the termination of a kind of organism or of a group of kinds, usually a species. The movement of extinction is generally considered of the species, although the capacity to breed and recover may have been lost before this point. These are the few images of extinct animals. My team members, everyone, have given their efforts in creating social responsibility awareness about extinct animals. Thank you. Over to Shanmita to talk about list of extinct animals.
That was a wonderful introduction, Janani. Good evening, everyone. I am Shanmita from Class 7, Medavakkam, and in this presentation, we'll see about the periods of the mass extinction. Starting from over 440 to 65 million years ago, there have been 5 mass extinctions on Earth. Now, let's see about one dominant species in each of the periods. Firstly, we have late Ordovician Silurian period, donkey lost years. It existed during the late Devonian period, which was about 358 to 382 million years ago. It is said that a massive asteroid was blocking out the sun and was playing havoc with the climate and killed these donkey losters. We move on to Devonian period, therapids. Therapids are mammal-like reptiles, and it is said that the mammal-like reptiles, they were the dominant species from the early Permian to the late Jurassic period. These mammal-like reptiles included the cynodonts. What is cynodonts? Cynodonts mean the group that gave rise to the mammals in the late Jurassic period, and these therapids went extinct at the end of the Jurassic period. We move on to Permian-Jurassic period, Helicoprion. It is the genus of extinct shark-like endemic holoceratid fish. And the unique feature about this fish is its lower jaw is modified like a saw to catch prey easily. And it is as fast as today's fastest shark. And it lived from 290 to 250 million years ago. We move on to Triassic-Jurassic period, Spinosaurus. It is also known as Spinosaurid dinosaur, and it lived from 99 to 93.5 million years ago. It is also the largest of all carnivorous dinosaurs, and the unique feature about this dinosaur is it can swim, breed, and it can even hunt underwater, and it can also breed and hunt on land also. The last period of the five mass extinctions, Cretaceous-Tertiary period, Shandongosaurus. It is also known as Shandong lizard, and it is a single species. It is found in the late Cretaceous Washing group of the Shandong Peninsula in China. It weighs 18 tons, which is now the weight of a full-sized school bus, and it lived from 100.5 to 66 million years ago. I want you all to take a closer look at this pic. You may see a dinosaur crocodile there. Well, then you may ask me, Shanmita, why didn't the crocodiles go extinct and we are able to see them in this period also? It is because the crocodiles went deep underwater to save themselves from extinction. Thank you. Over to Kavya.
Thank you for your wonderful speech, Shanmita. Thank you for your wonderful speech, Shanmita. Hey guys, myself Kavya T and I'm from 7th Standard Chambaram branch. Now let's talk about endangered animals to be extinct. Now let's talk about what is extinct endangered? Animals which have high risk of getting extinct, okay? Now let's talk more about endangered species. endangered animals. Now let's talk about critically endangered animals. Let's see top four endangered species. Our leopards, black rhinos, bonnet are four endangered species. We are talking about. So these species are in very low amount and can get extinct at any time. As we already saw the foremost endangered species, now let's talk about them. The Amur leopards. The Amur leopards live in southeastern Russia and northern China. It is listed in the IUCN Red List 2007. Only 1927 wild leopards were surviving because of deforestation and habitat loss. Population of the Amur leopards is still decreasing. Now let's talk about black rhinos. Black rhinos live in Angola, Asia, Zambia, etc. It is hunted by humans for its very valuable horn. To trade in the rhinos horn trading system, after this black rhinos population went down very lowly, and then the government banned the horn trading system, and surprisingly, it worked. The population of the black rhinos is increasing day by day. In our list, the third animal is the Bornean orangutan. The Bornean orangutans live in the island of Borneo together with Sumatran orangutan and Tapanuli orangutan. It belongs to the great apes family. The Bornean orangutan's population is 1,04,700, and the Sumatran orangutan's population is 7,500 in the world. Population of the Bornean orangutan is still decreasing. Now let's talk about river cross gorillas. River cross gorillas is the family of the western gorillas. It was named a new species in 1904 by Paul Marcy in Berlin. But its population were not systematically survived until 1987. Population of the river cross gorillas are still getting low. Now let's talk about how to prevent the animals from extinction. You can plant a tree on your every birthday and create a blog to create awareness about the endangered animals and extinct animals. Save animals from extinction, guys. I will end my speech and presentation here. Over to Tanushi.
Thank you, Kavya, for the informative presentation you have given about the list of endangered animals to be extinct. And now, I would like to introduce myself. I am Tanushi from Narayana Olympiad, Gopalapuram, Chennai. And today, I am going to give a presentation about the reasons and causes for extinction of animals. As you know, there are many reasons for extinction of animals. A few of them are change in climatic conditions due to human activities such as deforestation, habitat destruction, mining, infrastructural development, etc. These methods may lead to cut down of trees in large scale, in which many animals may lose their homes and lead to their extinction. Another reason for extinction of animals is due to increase in the number of predators, which results in the extinction of the prey. Though it is the food chain of a predator to eat its prey, it leads to their extinction. In olden days, humans used to hunt and kill animals for parts of their body such as teeth, fur, nails, and even skin, which were used for making craft works, ornaments, cosmetics, and even medicines. As you can see in the image I have shared, it is a chain made up of the tiger snail and the tusk of an elephant decorated as part of the craft work. Though the government has banned hunting of animals, there are many other reasons for extinction of animals, such as over-harvesting, pollution, greenhouse effect, etc. Also, due to natural phenomena, disasters like tornadoes, earthquakes, volcanic eruptions leads to extinction of animals. When endangered species of animals such as black panthers and giant pandas are not saved and preserved in wildlife sanctuaries, biosphere reserves and national parks, it leads to their extinction. I would like to end my presentation by passing on this presentation to my friend Dia, who would continue a few more reasons for extinction of animals. Thank you. Over to Dia.
Thank you. Anishi, that was a fabulous presentation. A warm welcome to my respected teachers and my dear friends. This is Diya from Class 7 PNM branch. Today, let's see the three important facts about why animals are extinct. They are overconsumption, population, and pollution. Let's start with overconsumption. Overconsumption is the killing of world's most precious wildlife from tigers to giraffes. The living planet repeats now more than 9,000 of the populations of mammals, reptiles, amphibians, and fish are faring vivid planet in this process with human health, wealth, and well-being. Next, we'll move on to population. Pollution may muddy landscape, poison soils and waterways, or even kill plants and animals. Long-term exposure to air pollution, predators can make some species unsafe to eat. Next, let's move on to population. Have you wondered that how population affects wildlife? Yes, more population results in more development, which also equals changes or reduction in habitat for wildlife. Therefore, wildlife numbers are reduced, many of those that survive wandering into urbanized areas. Also, extinction happens when environmental factors of evolutionary problems cause species to die out. Humans can also cause other species to become extinct by hunting, over-harvesting, introducing invasive species to wild, polluting and changing wetlands and forests to croplands and urban areas. So let's start to save our beauty of our earth, our wildlife. Here we are to the end of my presentation. I thank my respected teachers for this wonderful opportunity. Over to Amritan.
Thank you, Riya. It was an informative speech. Good morning, everyone. Myself Devamtham from Class 7 Tamil Branch. Here I was present to say about prevention of extinction. How to prevent extinction? One thing we humans fail at seeing is the big picture. We are often blind to the interconnectedness of everything that supports life, well, so complex and interdependent. We are only beginning to understand it. The food chain from the tiniest little microorganism to the largest creatures on earth keep us humans alive. When we talk about the grey whale, the timber wolf, the black rhino, it's not just that we should save these endangered creatures for their own good, but it's also for ours. The current legislation and government bodies that protect wild species from extinction are both being refunded and reorganized. It will be up to the ordinary citizens and environmental groups to save these important links on the food chain. Here are some ways to accomplish this. Educate your family about endangered species in your area. Grow native plants. Do not buy plastic products. Reduce your water consumption. Reduce your personal footprints. By these ways, you can save or you can donate some money to World Wildlife Fund, WWF, or you can write a blog and publish in Google so others also can know about extinct animals. These all our social responsibility to prevent extinct animals. Save the endangered animals to be extinct. Now I would like to end my presentation. Thank you everyone. Over to Mahati.
Hey Amritan, that was really informative. Now, as we all know, what is extinction? It is important for us to know the consequences of extinction. This is Mahati from Pudal branch here to explain you about the consequences of extinction. Some consequences of extinction are decrease in biodiversity, decrease in biomass, collapse in food web, and also loss of keystone species. Biodiversity. One of the major consequences of animal extinction is biodiversity. In layman terms, if there is any reduction in the existing species level, the balance of the ecosystem will be disturbed. For example, clearing trees or deforestation eliminates the shading, temperature and moisture regulation, and as well as animal habitat. The pictorial representation in this slide shows us clearly that the habitat loss is a major threat to the loss of biodiversity. Biomass. Biodiversity loss leads to the biomass reduction. In layman terms, in extinction of animals or plants in a certain habitat results in the loss of biological diversity. This can also be explained as the global extinction of species cannot be reversed. This would impact the human food supply chain as well. In this pictorial representation, mammals, birds constitute the top. Now, I'd like to end my presentation and over to Afroz. Thank you.
Thank you, Mahati. It was a nice speech. Good morning to one and all present here. I'm Afroz from Class 7th, Valasaravakam branch. Today, I'm going to talk about how to conserve animal life. Animal life is a precious gift from the God for this planet. The non-domesticated life forms, including birds, insects, plants, fungi, and even a microscopic organism. To maintain a healthy ecological balance on this land, animals, plants, and myriad species as important as humans. Every organism on this earth has a unique place in food chain that contributes to the ecosystem in its own way. But unfortunately, today many animals and birds are endangered. Natural habits of animals and plants are destroyed for the land development and agriculture by humans. Poaching and hunting of animals for fur, jewelry, meat, leather are other important factors contributing to the extinction of animals. It could not be long when they find a place on the list of extinct species, and that could not be all. The extinction of the wild species will certainly have a fatal impact on human race. So for us human beings, it becomes great responsibility to save the animal and our planet, and mostly importantly ourselves. Here are some other reasons for the deep understanding why. The ecosystem is entirely based on the relationship between the different organisms linked by the food webs and food chains. Even if a single microscopic organism, wild species, dies around the ecosystem, it can distribute the entire food chain and lead to a disaster results. Similarly, if a species become larger, it may again have a negative effect on the ecological balance. Considered another simple case on carnivores that is shrinking every day because of the human poaching and hunting. The reduction of these carnivores leads to an increase in the number of herbivores that depends on the forest vegetation for the survival. It could not be long when the number of herbivores in the forest could rise to such an extent that they could not move to the farmland and villages for their food needs. The saving animals plays an important role in controlling the ecological balance containing a healthy ecosystem. Thank you for giving a wonderful opportunity. My social responsibility is planting and stopping cutting of trees. Over to my friend Deva Samruthan. Thank you.
Thank you, Afroz, for the informative speech. Good morning, everyone. Myself, Deva Samruthan from Class 7th Tamaram branch. Now I would like to conclude my speech by overall view of extinct animals. The conclusion. What is extinction? The fact or process of species, family or other group of animals or plants becoming extinct. List of extinct animals. Savory toothed cat, dodo bird, woolly mammoth, grey dog are some of the extinct animals. Animals in endangered to be extinct. Amur leopard, black rhino, Boronian orangutan, cross river gorilla are some of the animals in endangered to be extinct. Reason for extinction. There are 5 major causes of extinction. Habitat loss and introduced species, population, pollution, overconsumption. Prevention of extinction. Recycle and buy sustainable products. Reduce your water consumption. Reduce your personal footprint. Educate your family about endangered species in your area. Conservation of animal life. Adopt from wild animals to wild places, that's an option for everyone. Or just donate some money to zoo or World Wildlife Fund WWF. The link has been given below. Please click that link to donate, or there's an option to adopt. As for social responsibility, our team has made an awareness on extinct animals. Our team have made blog links which have been given below. These are our blog links which our team has made to create awareness on extinct animals. Now I would like to share an information. World Animal Day is celebrated at October 4. Why is Animal Day celebrated? Animal Day is to raise the status of animals in order to improve welfare standards around the globe. Everyone, please share our blog links or create your own blog links and share to your relatives, friends, society to create awareness on extinct animals. We hope that our team presentation gives you more information on extinct animals. Save the endangered animals to be extinct. Thank you, my respective surgical trainers, Madhumita ma'am, Surendra sir, and TL Geeta ma'am, and our respective HOD, Veda ma'am. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you so much for taking us to the era of dinosaurs, black rhinos, and many more animals. And as an initiator of creating social awareness, we as a team have created already the blog to create awareness about the extinct animal. Over to Surendra. Thank you.
Thank you, Madhu. That was a good presentation, Team Extinct Animal. And overall, it was a wonderful presentation given by all the four teams, wild animal, domestic animal, pet animals, and extinct animal. I know this is a vast topic, and that's why the time has also been taken a lot. And we hope the time, whichever you have spent, is effective and informative as well. So thank you so much, team. Over to Veda ma'am for your suggestions, feedback.
Wonderful presentation, students. I must definitely appreciate each and every student, the SOSCA department, teachers, the principals, and special thanks to all the parents who have allowed their students to work on this wonderful topic. And what an informative one. You name it and it is available in the presentation. And definitely I would like to say that Deva Amritam, please share all the blog links and we will like to circulate it to all the the schools of Narayana Institution, and request all the parents also to share it with the rest of their parents, and we will ensure that there is some information shared from central office too. That's a very good initiative and very well presented. And I wish all of you come out with such a wonderful ideas. And I can see the love towards animals. That emotional bonding was very, very expressive. I must definitely thank my team, Madhumita, Peter Manoj, Indra, and Surendra, for giving us such a wonderful presentation. Thank you all. It is really informative. And in fact, you all made my day today with Animal Kingdom presentation. Thank you all.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am, for your valuable feedbacks to our children. Now, I'd like to invite Geeta, ma'am, also to share your feedbacks, ma'am.
It was wonderful, Surinder. Thank you very much, students. It was very informative for all of us. We learned from you today. Thank you very much. And a special thanks to all the teachers and parents who involved in this.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so
much,
ma'am.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
From our end, we would like to thank Veda ma'am and Geeta ma'am for giving a wonderful platform for the children to showcase their talent virtually, ma'am, here, since we are not connected. Thank you so much, ma'am, for this wonderful opportunity. And I would also like to thank all the parents who have supported, who stood close to their kids, training them, encouraging them, and motivating them. So thank you, parents, for your support as well. And all the principals, teachers who supported their children to participate. And finally, my team who stood with me, trained my team, spent time with my team, understanding each and every kids, and trained accordingly. So I would like to thank all my trainers, Madhumita, Peter Manoj, Indra. So here I would like to say, wild animal team has been trained by Peter Manoj, and domestic animal team has been trained by Indra, and pet animal trained by myself, and extinct animal trained by Madhumita. Thank you so much, team.
And thank you very much, Shashank sir, for his continuous support.
Yes, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, ma'am. With this, I would like to conclude.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Veda ma'am and Geeta ma'am for the wonderful support.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, Veda ma'am. Thank you, Geeta ma'am, and everyone, all the students.
Too. And our